What's going on, guys? Your boy Terabyt Reacts here, and we are back, Terra Squad, with another Code Geass super reaction. Today we're going to be diving into episode 12 through 14, I think. So I'm ready for this ride, man. Last three episodes were a bit more in depth. Not much action, there was some action, but I'm here for the smarts. You know what I'm saying? I'm here for Lelouch outsmarting everybody. Okie dokes, surprises. That's what I'm here for. And also, the political aspects of this anime is very, very intriguing. So, we're going to jump into this, man. You guys know what's happening from the last episode, how it ended. Two of the Knights of the Round, along with Suzaku, is now a part of the high school. So, who knows what's going to happen with these two around, right? Plus, we still have Rolo, you know, on our side. So, let's see what happened. I'm excited to jump into this. So, I'll see you guys for the review. If you want to see me talking about the last three episodes, go back and check out that video, of course. And you will know what I thought of those three episodes and where we are up to this point. But let's jump into this reaction, man. I'm excited to see this. So let's get it. See you guys for the reaction. If you do not know, link is in the description. Okay? I'm telling you guys. Link is in the description. Full reaction. Go ahead and click on it. You have two options. Google Drive and bitchute.com. Okay? Thank you guys for listening. See you guys for the review. What's going on, guys? It's your boy Terabyt Reacts here, and we are going to be reviewing episodes 12 through 14 of Code Geass R2. I mean, this anime is so good, man. It's so good to the point where you're like, at one point I was wondering, because there was so much different things going on. Okay, so in episode 12 we had the thing that the president, the school president, was doing of the student council. She was going to graduate, right? So she wanted to become a weather girl or whatever the situation is, but before she left, she wanted to do this cupid thing she wanted to do at school. So basically, if you steal a boy's hat, you're officially girlfriend and boyfriend at school, right? But she sent everybody after Lelouch, right? So, but essentially what I got from that episode was that no matter how you fight things, if you're meant to be with each other, which is a very romantic episode, no matter how you fight against something, because I mean, imagine she didn't have her memories and she still fell back in love with Lelouch, surely. So that's why in the next episode, in episode 13, that it was such a powerful moment where she was dying and she's saying, no matter what, it's like, no matter how they screw up my memories, no matter if, you know what I'm saying, no matter how much you know, even though you were responsible for my father's debt, it's like, I still love you. So that was a very, very powerful scene, you know, really got to me there, because I just had that feeling, man. You know what I'm saying? I just had that feeling that something was going to happen to her, and it did. So those two episodes were really good episodes, but they turned it up 200, 300, 500, 1,000% in episode 14, because Lelouch started to act now out of straight emotions. I'm kind of glad that, you know, Mr. Orange is on our side now, because he was with Lelouch's mother, Marianne, when she was killed and stuff, and he was serving her. I don't know if it's a love thing or whatever the situation is, but he felt for Lelouch because he was supposed to be protecting her, and I guess she died under the command. And I'm guessing that Cornelia now is probably, because I think Lelouch is the one that just saved her in that episode before the place blew up. But Lelouch was transferred the same way how she transferred him to the island there. I think it was at the end of season one, right? So it's crazy what's going on right now. So many things to talk about. But my thing is, him finding out about where the experiments were happening, it looked like they're mass producing Geass users. I thought it was like maybe a few, maybe like, but they have kids there with Geass powers. I mean, and Rolo knows them. Now, Rolo killing Shirley, his sense of duty. I mean, he could have read into what she was saying, but you know, he acts on impulse. So it's like, oh, so you want to tell our secret? I can't let that happen. But killing her was a bit too much. You get what I'm saying? I think that's the part of him that I don't like. Like, remember back before Lelouch turned him, he was just killing people just for them being in the freaking room. It's just like, dude, you know what I'm saying? Like, nobody can know about the Geass. Nobody. If they know about the Geass, oh, they gotta die. You know what I mean? So it's like, that's the part of it. That's the part of him that I don't like. I like the fact that he's working with Lelouch and all of this and all of that, but that part of him, I can't be down with. You know what I mean? Like, I just can't be down with that part of him. That part of him is a bit obscured. Like, it's just off to me. Like, if you're just a pure-blooded assassin, you know what I mean? Like, I mean, Jesus, man, he's heartless. And the thing about it is that he's conflicted because he actually loves Lelouch as a brother. But it's just like the whole thing about nobody knowing about the Geass. If they know about the Geass, oh, they gotta die. If they're regular. You know what I'm saying? So it seems like only Geass users should know about Geass users. So it's like, it's nuts. So it's just crazy. Because, I mean, why not kill Suzaku then? You know what I'm saying? But I guess because he's a knight of the round, why he never went after Suzaku. Because I'm pretty sure he knows. He knows because he's an undercover agent. He knows that Suzaku knows about the Geass. So, next episode, we're going to get to see what happens. Now the Emperor is talking to Lelouch again. So, we're going to see what this conversation is going to entail. Now that he's in this space with him, looking at how they plan to kill God and all of this other stuff. I'm sure Lelouch is going to have a good conversation with him this time around, because he's not being forced, you know what I'm saying? So he can't really command him to do anything, because he already used his Geass on him, so I'm guessing he can't use it on him again, you know what I'm saying? So I don't know what's gonna happen, you know. So I mean, these were three really good episodes, man. You know, and I just can't get over the fact that people don't like this anime. It's just like, yes, sometimes some things are a little bit off. Like, I think the last episode there, episode 14, was a bit rushed. But I understood. They were basically, to me, and this is my opinion, I feel like what the writer was trying to portray here is how quickly we can act on our emotions. You get what I'm saying? Shirley being dead, he's ready to kill Rolo because he knows that Rolo killed Shirley. And he's acting solely based on the fact that he never wanted to lose Shirley again. I mean, if you've seen that scene, man, when he's constantly using the Geass, commanding her to not die, and it's not working. It's not working. She still ended up dying, which is a character that I'm sad to see go, because as I was saying before, in previous times when I was talking about them, I'm like, yo, Shirley is that moral center for him. And every character, no matter what, you need a moral center. Just like me, I have a moral center outside of myself, right? I have a person that I go to and I talk to about certain things, You know what I'm saying? Just to have a different perspective about things, man. Because sometimes you might think you know everything and you might be doing everything right, but it's not, it doesn't roll like that. You know what I'm saying? So I'm happy, man. I'm happy that they did something like that, because it shows you how quickly you can rush into things based on just emotions. Even though Lelouch may be smart, I really didn't expect him to come out of this with a win, to be honest, because the whole time I was thinking, man, you're rushing into this, bro. You should have calmed down. Think about it a little. You know what I'm saying? So, and then Suzaku is trying to get some information out of Kalen. That's also something. But the great battle they had against Vivi there. I don't know what the Emperor is planning, man. What is he planning? Because it doesn't look like he's happy with what Vivi did. So, I don't know. But I guess we will see. Okay, so thank you guys for tuning in once again, man. This anime has got me, like, I have a headache just thinking about this stuff sometimes. Because it's so interesting. It's so interesting. The parallels that you can draw from it is just so awesome. You know what I mean? So, thank you guys for watching as always, man. If you have not subscribed yet, subscribe to the channel. Leave a like on this video and also leave a comment in the comment section. You guys have been doing really good. I think we're averaging somewhere like around 200 views per upload now, per reaction. So I'm glad to see that. So thank you guys for watching as always. It's your boy Terabyt Reacts. See you on the next one.